People who walked the path of Bhakti Margam considered God as their own father and mother and surrendered themselves in that seva. Andal praised Kannan as her lover and united with him. 63 Nayanmas got blessings just by surrendering themselves at the feet of Mahadev. Yogis like Sivanandar, Paramahamsar, Aurobindo, Vallalar felt the God by their intense yogic practices. Many people experience the Almighty in various forms to pay their respects. However, nobody in history has considered God as their own child. Yogini Shivagami Ammayar was one such person who considered Lord Subramanya as her own son and dedicated her entire life to build and develop his temple. Each breath of her was filled by Lord Subramanya's name. With the divine grace from the Lord himself, she had carried out enormous work which could not be done neither by a rich person nor in one's entire life. Shivagami Ammayar was born into a wealthy and benevolent family. Her parents were Muthuswami Thevar and Vaimuli Ammayar. As per documents, she was born around 1784. From her childhood, she was a person with full devotion in heart. Once she reached the adulthood, she got married to Kangamuthu Thevar, son of Sangumuthu and Uttami Ammal. After marriage, the couple lived a peaceful life by helping the villagers in various ways. For example is the bridge that they built on Hanuman River, which is still known as the Kangamuthu Bridge. They treated all the people equally, even having a personal attendant from a lower caste by the name Sangili Madan, who spent his entire life in service of Lord along with Shivagami Amma. Since the couple was not having a child of their own, they considered all the village children as their own and built a mutt in the village to serve saints who were coming into the village. Shivagami Ammayar spent a lot of wealth by offering food to the sages. This made the relative jealous and they started spoil her image among the villagers by spreading rumors. Shivagami Ammayar tolerated everything they did. But finally, when they talked about her virginity, she became furious and cursed that particular family by saying, "If I am a Dharmapatini, let the thunder fall on the house," and she left the place. It was a mid-afternoon, there was no sign of rain, but within a few seconds a thunder came and that particular person's house has been destroyed. Even today one can witness the house in the village where the thunder fell. This particular incident gave a warning to Shivagami Ammayar relatives and they stopped talking about her. But the couple were very sad about not having a child. One day, an Islamic saint by the name Valar Mastan visited Shivagami Ammayar mutt and he stayed few days there. When he was about to leave the village, he called Shivagami Amma and said, "Daughter, I know your problem. You are not blessed with a child and cannot become a mother. But there is another purpose for you to fulfill. Visit Tirumalai Murugan temple in Panbulli. Consider that particular deity as your own son and serve him for the rest of your life." And he left the village. Without having any second thought, Shivagami Ammayar left to Tirumalai Murugan temple along with her husband and the domestic help Sangili Madan. Tirumalai Murugan temple is dedicated to Lord Tirumalai Kumara Swami, situated near Tenkasi in Tirunelveli district of Tamil Nadu. It is believed that this small shrine has been built by a Kerala king by name Pandala Maharaja, who has built the famous Sabarimalai Ayyappan temple. Tirumalai Murugan temple is located in a small hillock surrounded by a thick forest. Villagers were scared to go to the temple even during daytime. But Shivagami Ammayar went there, felt that her own son Tirumalai Kumaran was alone in that remote place without taken care by anyone. So she decided to be with him until her last breath. She started renovating the temple by building the mandapas in front of the Moolasthana, by raising the fund from the nearby zamindars. However, it was not sufficient as the temple was not up to the satisfaction. Hence, she sold all her property and along filed cases against the person who was illegally possessing the temple property belonging to the Lord in Puliyarai village in the Thiruvananthapuram court. By showing the epigraphy evidence, she recovered all the land belonging to the temple. She continued renovating the temple with more valor and support to the Lord blessings. She used elephants and few hundred villagers to carry the stones to the top of the hill. In those times, heavy ropes were not invented, so they used palm leaf rope to pull the rocks. Sometimes due to the heavy weight, the ropes got cut and the huge stones rolled down to the foothills. At that time, Shivagami Amma dared her life and ran towards the stones and stopped them by holding her head against the falling stones to avoid getting rolled down further. She remained in the same position until the rocks has been pulled up again. Like this, she had done so many miracles in front of the villagers by Subramanya's grace. These incidents made the villagers believe the yogic power of Shivagami Ammaya. Another such miracle happened at Trichendu. When she went to Trichendu to collect more palm ropes to support her temple renovation project, it happened to be Shasti festival when she went to Trichendur, and the famous chariot festival was on the procession. In that time, Shivagami Ammal got humiliated by a security guard of the chariot when she came in front of the chariot to get Subramanya's darshan. Security guard pushed her away to the back side of the chariot due to her sadhu appearance. Within few minutes, the chariot was not moving despite multiple attempts. The Gurukul of the temple came forward and said, "Someone humiliated the divine bhakti of Subramanya. Only upon touched by that person, the chariot will move." Shivagami Ammal came forward and touched the chariot. Upon her touch, the chariot started moving. This was seen by all the zamindars and the rich people of Trichendu who came for the Shasti festival. They saw the yogic powers of Yogini Shivagami Amma and supported her seva of renovating the temple by providing the palm ropes free of cost. Many people started visiting the temple once the renovation work got over. Shivagami Ammal stayed at the foothills of Tirumalai Murugan temple at Vandadum Pottal and continued her service to the Lord. People who came to get the blessings of Lord Subramanya visited Shivagami Ammal and got her blessings too. Shivagami Ammal's guru Valar Mastan used to bless everyone as Manampol Valvu, means your life is based on your thoughts. She repeated the same lines whenever she offered the prasadam to anyone who visited and sought her blessings. She made several references discreetly about to attain Jiva Samadhi and often quoted the date. On 9th June 1854, she left her physical body and attained Jiva Samadhi. She never wanted anyone to remember her or recognize her for the works she did. She never left any inscriptions that spoke about her and her activities for the temple. She spent her entire life only for Thirumurugan's services by seeing him in each person and object. Daily puja and worship rituals are performed in her Jiva Samadhi. Guru Puja celebration is conducted every year on the day of Vaikasi Visakham. May Tirumalai Kumaran and Shivagami Ammal bless us all with good health, sustained happiness forever. Om Sharvana Bhavaya Namaha. Thank you.